Cognitive dissonance is a killer. I mean, literally. I am still reporting from the fence, caught between choosing one vaccine over another, choosing when to receive whichever vaccine, choosing whether to receive a vaccine, choosing whether to order ivermectin and pay the $149 for 30 doses to have on hand, ivermectin being the treatment of choice should one actually contract the virus, choosing. If you've been following my chapters, you know that the most recent installment revealed that a diagnosis I received about 20 years ago has re-emerged. The diagnosis has. The symptoms had re-emerged from a childhood version of it, mast cell disease. And in the time between my last installment and the moment, I have been in consult with a couple immunologists' offices, local and Cleveland Clinic. Cleveland Clinic won't be able to virtually meet with me until the 15th of this month. So while I was to have had a first dose of Pfizer tomorrow, I have since decided to push that out to the 15th locally, same day that I actually meet virtually with the immunologist at the Cleveland Clinic, who will not, I'm told by his office, recommend a vaccine or not a vaccine to a mast cell patient unless that patient has been seen by him. So I finally calculated that I should at least wait until after he has gone over my symptoms, gone over any test results that we might be able to obtain, and made his determination for me. Guess what I did last night and today? I went to the VAERS website and figured out, thanks to Dr. Mobeen Syed, and his tutorial on the topic, a month and a half's worth of serious adverse reactions to Pfizer. And I scrolled through all of them. There were 324 in a month. Is that a lot? Most of those, about 3/4 of them, were elderly folks with multiple comorbidities who died. Some weren't. Some were not described. Their ages weren't revealed, or their allergies and their pre-existing conditions weren't listed, just that there was death. Some list multiple medications and supplements, and a handful sounded a lot like me. You know, they took their vitamins and their supplements and their minerals, and their lifestyle suggested this or that or the other thing, and they died after one dose in a matter of days. Do we chalk this up to hidden comorbidities, diseases as yet undiagnosed? Or, you know, it even occurs to me, do we chalk it up to anti-vaxxers going to the VAERS website and falsely entering data in an attempt to skew the outcome of this rollout of the Pfizer vaccine? If you click on the link, there's a code after each entry. And apparently if you click on those, you can get further details about the case. So I guess they have to be documentable, meaning they have to be provable. But here I am in this swarm, this nest, this web, this barbed wire playpen of dissonance, trying to resolve to a point of decision with which I can live. Literally live. And the thought occurred, is it that I love my life too much and that's why I'm afraid to lose it? The people who have the easiest time with all of this are the socially integrated, those whose decisions are driven by social mores, social habits, social patterns. Everything in their lives is determined by the interactions they have with other people. All the choices they make are based in their interactions with other people. Artists don't necessarily make decisions that are socially based. Most visual artists and poets, well, visual artists especially, make all their decisions in the vacuum of the inside of their creative world. And musicians who create music and don't require the presence of other musicians, or pianists who play alone largely, can make their decisions in their own little vacuum. For what do we want to live? To continue to eat good food that doesn't cause a reaction? To make music and art and other things beautiful alone? In the company of ourselves. I was weeping moments ago, and then I went and put a little, you know, articulation on the lips and combed my hair and did the little setup. It's awful. It's gut-wrenching to be stuck in cognitive dissonance. Why? Because friends of mine, people I love, people I've known for years, are at total peace living without even a second thought as to whether they're going to take that vaccine. They're just not going to, and they've got their little society of people who are all not going to. The people in their churches, primarily, and other people who are just Republicans. They're perfectly fine as long as they hang around with each other. And they don't get the vaccine, they can have their little lives. Or families, extended families that spend their time largely with one another. I have a set of cousins that has always lived that way just for their extended family, nobody else. I operate in a mixed bag. I teach children, I interact with their parents, I interact with other musicians, I have to play a wedding in May. I'm going out of my mind. And the group of those who, oh, I got my vaccine. Which one did you get? Oh, I'm one of the cool people. I got the Cadillac. I got the best vaccine. I got the cheaper one. I got the lesser one. But I'm just, you know, I'm a low life. So all these different levels of life, they're all, you know, swimming around, floating around, making their social decisions. Not me. Cognitive dissonance and the COVID vaccine is one of the wealthiest minds on the planet. Wealthiest minds. Is he really trying to kill us? Is it all about depopulation? Am I going to be a lab rat if I take that shot? What about you? The fact that I cannot know, I don't know where to go for reliable advice, makes me just want to read a book and stay home for the rest of my life. To be or not to be. The slings and arrows are still flying.